Hey YouTube, it's Eli, and today is January 29th, 2014, and I am 9.5 months on testosterone. Pretty excited and stoked to be reaching my 1 year mark. Changes, more facial hair is coming in, a little bit darker. I shaved this morning, so you can't really tell anything. Probably wondering why it looks the way it looks on YouTube, but I'm filming this on my phone since my computer decided it wanted to shut down on me. So yeah. Other changes, my chest fat is pretty much like it's there, but it's pretty much gone. There's only like a little bit. I'm so ready and wanting top surgery like yesterday, just to feel 100% comfortable in my body, you know, not 100%, but a little bit more comfortable in my body. Like, I like, right now I'm not wearing a binder and I am hunching a little bit because you can kind of see a little, but it's not like that big of a deal. Sometimes I forget. That I even have a female chest and will get ready to go outside to go to work or whatever and be like, oh shit, I need to put my binder on, or whatever. And I don't have to necessarily wear my binder because I am smaller and you can't fucking tell at all. But for security purposes and feeling comfortable outside, I wear it. And whatnot. I've recently started wearing my newer looking binder. I stopped wearing it because my asthma was bothering me and I was wearing my old binder, but now that I basically have an asthma doctor and I'm getting my asthma medicine regularly now, my lungs and my asthma has gotten better, and so I can wear my new binder and not have any issues with it feeling tight. Like, eventually, after a few hours, like 10 to 12 hours, I do take it off because then I can feel that I'm having trouble breathing, but for the most part, I'm good the whole time that I'm wearing it. And I wear my binder to work. So, yeah. Other changes. Growth in the pants has been nice, very gradual. I'm liking, it's a plus. Let's see, more body hair, stuff like that. I mean, everything's been gradual, nothing new or exciting or anything like that. Which is kind of cool. Ooh, I'm a little tired, it's early in the morning. Or whatever. Things that I've been dealing with on an emotional level, socially, would be, you know, people messing up pronouns here and there, people using words that would identify someone's gender, which case they're using wrong words like sister, daughter, all that bullshit, when that's not the case. And I know that it's taking people time to adjust and stuff like that, but some days, like, I don't want you to be adjusting. I want you to fucking just do it. Like, this is who I am. This is not a joke. This is not a phase. This is how I'm going to live the rest of my life, so get with the program. That's how I feel. sometimes when, you know, people mess up, it just makes me... It brings me down. It makes me feel like they truly don't understand, or they truly don't see me as the male that I am, which is a really big downer for me. Whoa, I almost fell off the chair. What else? There was another thought to that whole thing. There it goes. Sometimes... when people mess up, it kind of just makes me question myself. Not question myself if I'm doing this the right thing or anything like that, but just the whole, like, am I really passing, or, you know, like, sometimes when I look at my photos, I do see a change, but more so the change is the weight that I lost. You know, I was 185 to 195 a month or so before starting testosterone, and the most I weighed was 2-something pre-transition. So I have lost quite a lot of weight in the last year or two. And that's what I feel. Like, I feel like when people say, oh, he, la 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 la, you know, it's great that they're adjusting themselves, but then it's just like, really, am I passing? Like, to other people, when they see me, they see, like, a 17-year-old boy, which is okay. I look young. I will probably forever look young, or whatever. And I know that I pass to strangers, but, like, to people that know me, it's like, do I really pass to them? Like, do they see that I've changed, or do they see what I see when I hear things like that sometimes? Do they just see, wow, you know, he's lost a lot of weight? And, yay. Just, you know, that's cool. I'm happy that I lost a lot of weight, but, like, I don't know. Like, I just, sometimes I feel like, I know that I'm in the beginning of my transition, but I feel like I wish I was farther along. Like, I feel like more, like, if I had top surgery, my brain would just be like, you know, yes, I have more of a masculine body as opposed to before. And it is more masculine, like, my hourglass is kind of not so houry. I don't think that's a word. It's more straight. I still have kind of curves, but you can't really tell. My hips are smaller, which is fucking awesome. You can't really tell. I have the more masculine-looking body, but then there's those moments when I jump in the shower or I take off my shirt and I realize, oh, fuck, you know, I have, you know, fucking tits. Like, and it's not even boobs or anything like that. It's just, like, the leftover fat of my chest fat that's there, and just need to cut that shit out, and I'll be okay, and things will be good, and when I look down, I don't have to feel stressed out, or just like, yeah, I still have these, and I don't know when I'm gonna cut them off, and, you know, I don't know, things don't work fast for me because that's not my life. Things are never handed down to me because that's not my life. Like, I will forever and always have to work my ass off to get the things that I want. And that's just how it is. I don't expect anyone to, you know, be like, here, this is for you. And, you know, you don't have to worry about it. And blah, blah, blah. And whatever. And don't get me wrong. I've had people help me thousands of times. Like, my sorority sisters and, you know, my really close friends, they've been there for me through thick and thin. I'm not saying that, you know, I have nobody, but it's just, I'm transgender. The fuck? All of my friends are cisgender people. Like, no one, there's, like, I have two trans friends that, trans friends where I know that I can just be like, blah, 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 and they will just text me back or message me back and be like, dude, I know what you're feeling. Like, this is what I've done to get over it. You know, and it's, you know, I feel completely fine talking to other trans people because they understand. You know, they know, and, you know, it's okay, and I'm comfortable talking about it. Whereas if I were to bring up a conversation about how I felt about my chest to someone, they won't understand because they don't know what it is to feel like to be trans, you know, like, they just don't. And yeah, I often feel like I don't fit in anywhere, maybe with my friends or my family or just random people, sometimes I just feel like I don't fit in. I don't fit in with the girls because I'm not a girl, and I don't fit in with the guys because they don't see me as a guy. You know, they see me as someone who's strange, probably someone pretending to be a guy or trying to be a guy or thinking that they're a guy, so they're going through this and blah, blah, blah. Like, which is, you know, that's not true. You know, I know that I'm a guy. Like, you know, I wouldn't be doing this if I knew otherwise. But yeah, that's just the life of transitioning, I guess. You know, feeling kind of alone. Like, I feel accepted and I feel loved and supported by so many people, but then there's those days when those things really don't matter because the rest of the world sucks ass. And I know I shouldn't think about the rest of the world and I shouldn't be bothered by the rest of the world, but that's reality. You know, like, I started going to work with a pocket knife in my pocket. Not because I have any intentions of hurting anyone, no. I would smash a fly, but, you know, I would never started a fight with anyone, never been a violent type of person, angry type of person. I always keep things to myself. You know, I'm just not like that. That's very much out of my character. But it makes me feel safe. It does. You know, like I said, I have no intentions of using it. But for safety precautions, yeah, I'm going to have it in my pocket. And if you happen to touch me in any kind of way or anything where I feel like I will be attacked or physically harmed, then, you know, you got to do what you got to do at the end of the day, is how I feel, or whatever. I know it's in my policies that I shouldn't be taking weapons to work or anything, because it is a knife, but, you know, I guess it would be easier if I talked to my store manager about the harassment I've been dealing with, which I have yet to make a video about, but, you know, maybe it would make things easier, or worse, or whatever. I just haven't mustered up the courage to talk to anybody. You know, I just kind of just started looking for another job and I was like, fuck it, I'm not saying anything to these people. I'm just going to fucking dipset and be like, peace, motherfucker. Like, I don't ever want to see you again. Granted, the store is really close to my house. But, yeah, it is what it is. I'm just living life and trying to be happy and stuff like that. There's one thing I want to share before I end this video, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I got a library card with my new name on it, with my name on it. It was fucking awesome. It was a harmless process. All I had to do was show my name change paperwork and a recent letter with my address on it, and boom, I got a library card. I had to pay $1 for it. So that was exciting, to get a library card with my name on it, or whatever. But so I used my library card, of course, to look up trans books, because I don't know, I'm not much of a reader, and so I don't know what kind of books I like or what genre of books I like or anything like that. So I decided to just go with transgender books because it's already gonna spark my interest, and yeah, why not? So I have two books. Well, I'm only gonna show you one. The other one is, the one I'm not showing you is a book by Chaz Bono. It's his biography. I haven't started reading that, but I will, and I'll probably talk about that, you know, when I start reading that. But the book I'm currently reading is called I Am Jay. You can kind of see that, by Chris Beam. It is fucking awesome. I had no idea. I've never heard about this book, nothing. I just typed in transgender in the search bar and it popped up as a fiction book, and I'm just like, what? Decided to pick it, decided to look for it to see if it was even there, and it was, so I was just like, fuck it, I'm gonna take it. I didn't read the back. I didn't read the inside. I was like, it's a trans book. Fuck it. Like, I'm just going to read it. And if I don't like it, I don't like it. I am currently on chapter 4. I tried to read whenever I'm off work, but I just started reading like 2 days ago. I'm a slow reader or whatever and whatever. But I was reading this book and as I like kind of just got into it, you know, the person's name is Jay in this book, and he is a trans guy who happens to be Jewish and Puerto Rican. Now, I'm not Jewish or know anything about the Jewish culture or anything, but I'm Puerto Rican, and when, you know, he said, I'm Jewish and Puerto Rican, I was just like, that's like two different races together. I've never heard of a Jewish Puerto Rican before, so that's fucking cool. And then the fact that, you know, they have Puerto Rican, they're from New York, they're in high school, Jay's 17, and just trying to figure out what he's figuring out. Right now I got to the part where he's pretty much did his research online and figured out that he may be transgender, but he doesn't really know, and all of this other stuff, and it's pretty awesome. I actually finally feel like I connect and can relate to a character in a book that on more levels than just one, you know. Like, there are other books out there about Puerto Ricans and living in the hood and struggling and all of that other stuff and life and all of that shit, but a trans Puerto Rican Jew, like, can't forget the Jewish part, you know, is pretty fucking awesome. Like, that's amazing and cool, and I probably will spend the day reading this book because I have nothing else to do on my day off, and it's cold outside, so yeah. It's just really exciting, and I posted on my Facebook about this book and was just like, what are the chances of that? I didn't know anything about this book, and now I'm reading about a Puerto Rican Jew trans guy, and it's fucking awesome. I recommend it to whoever, you know, whoever's looking for a book to read. And maybe I'll do that. Like, I decided that one of my New Year's resolutions would be reading a book once a month. Granted, I started a several days late into January, but I figure when I make my videos and stuff, I could talk about a book that I'm reading and recommend it to anybody who's watching these videos who just wants to pick up something to read on their free time and stuff like that. But that's it for now, YouTube. I hope everyone is doing great and staying warm wherever you are in the part of the world, or staying cool if you're in, you know, down south or whatever, and it's hot, or warm, or whatever, wherever you are, whatever type of day. See you, YouTube. Bye.